Okay, so we were talking about the challenges of distributed Scrum and looking at some different models was one thing we did. We looked at isolated teams, having independent Scrum teams located in different locations and managing the team boundary. Distributed teams, the single Scrum team in multiple locations, and the case with a remote product owner and team members in a different location from the product owner. And here are some of the benefits and disadvantages of those three models.
Well, it is getting the communication right. It is communication collaboration, isn't it?
Yeah.
Try and make it as local as possible.
Yeah, so good principle is to think about how could we have these teams work like they were working closely in space. So any kind of technological things that we can do, build a portal between the different sites, put a webcam on both of the sites, and put a projector projecting the picture from the other side, so you could see the other people working there. So you create kind of a feeling of being in the same project, and also can enhance the communications. You know people by their faces and things like this.
Yeah. So part of it is really having rapport and really understanding how each of us work as a team, imagining the ideal circumstances, and then looking at all the different tech tools and techniques we can use to keep those same interactions going when we're not co-located, distributed. And we have so many technologies around these days. We've got the technology, it's just a case of using it, really, and having it really accessible.
Did you want to go through the advantages and disadvantages we explicitly covered?
Okay, so we kind of said there were different benefits and disadvantages to each of the models. Probably the reason for using each of the models is different. For the isolated teams, we said it was quite easy to establish trust within those individual Scrum teams because they are co-located.
Can we ask all the doctors to circle in the middle of the
and
room
I'm being interrupted.
We also
thought for those teams it would be more efficient to make decisions because they could make them locally. But a lot of the problems there can be that it's difficult when those teams in different locations need to make decisions together. So there's a lot of contention about decisions. It's difficult to share knowledge. There's different cultures and things like that. So they will impact the communication between the two teams. The distributed team, we said one of the benefits is that it forces the teams to actually communicate because they're working on the same team and they need to coordinate on a daily basis. So even though communication is hard, they do have to do it every day. One of the difficulties with this, distributed teams is establishing trust. So some of the ideas around that are to actually get together face-to-face initially before you start the project to build that trust. And then finally, the remote PO case. There's a lot of problems with that. The PO may not be available. There's a lot of delayed feedback to the teams. And there can be a lack of trust between the PO and the teams. The only benefits we could come up is that obviously that means the PO might be sitting closer to the customers. And they might be in a location that has the domain knowledge which you wouldn't have otherwise. Commonly something you might see in an outsourcing model. So for each of those, we came up with some tips. I guess the summary is don't do it unless you have to do it. If you do have to do it, then make sure you're aware of the problems and come up with some solutions to solve them.
Thank you very much. Anybody else have anything to say, add?
It's all about communication.
That's a quote.